Greetings from Indian Medical Association and EMED News. I am Dr. K.K. Agarwal, National Vice President-elect IMA. Welcome to our show, Chat with Dr. K.K. We have with us Dr. Kirti M. Patel, who is a medical oncologist by profession, who is the chairman of National Social Security Scheme of IMA. And along with him, we have Dr. Yogendra S. Modi, who is a secretary of the National Social Security Scheme, who is a professor of surgery, surgeon by profession at the Municipal Medical College in Ahmedabad. Welcome to our show. Thank you for being with us.
So nice of you.
So the purpose of this interaction is so that 2.2 lakh doctors at a national level know about the security scheme. What happens today is when we come to a working committee meeting, when we come to a central council meeting, every time there is a presentation about this scheme, we go to a doctor, a president, secretary, so they are aware. But the general public, general membership is not aware. I know I've been the president of my branch 3 times. I've been the president of the State Medical Association once. And none of the time this security scheme was discussed in these 4 years of my tenureship. That means up to the grassroots level, this scheme is not present. So let's try to promote this scheme, what exactly it is. Just tell us about this scheme in detail.
Indian Medical Association has established Indian Medical Association National Social Security Scheme in 1995. It is a scheme benefit to the nominee of a member. On the death of a member, the nominee gets a contribution from Indian Medical Association National Social Security Scheme. To become the member of National Social Security Scheme, member has to fill up the form, he has to apply for the membership for Indian Medical Association National Social Security Scheme. Any life member of Indian Medical Association below 40 years, or if a member is between 40 to 60 years, he must be a 3 years life membership to become the member of Indian Medical Association National Social Security Scheme. By giving a nominal fee for admission fee, as well as by giving the 5,000 rupees as a security for paying the money to the
AFC.
AFC, advanced fraternity contribution, he becomes the member of the social
security. So if I want to become a member, how much I have to pay?
Depending upon the age.
Okay, 53. Let's say 53.
53, then you have to give the 50 rupees as an admission fee.
50 rupees.
Then 5,000 rupees as a deposit.
One time
deposit. And 5,000 as an advanced fraternity contribution.
So total 10,000?
Total, I think, for 53 years is 8,050 rupees.
Okay, and after that, I have to pay every year?
After that, every year, you have to give 100 multiplied by the debt on that year. If there are 40 days, then 100 multiplied by 40, you have to give
4,000 rupees. That means I am contributing 100 rupees for any member who is dying per death.
Yeah.
Okay. In any way, that's what my commitment is.
Yeah.
So when I go to pay homage to a person, I spend much more than that.
Very true.
Okay, if I feel that IMA is my extended family, and then 100 rupees is a peanut.
Yeah.
If you're paying it per family, it's peanut.
Right.
100 rupees in the death of the members of the IMA National Social Scheme.
Obviously, who is a member? NSS membership is my extended family.
Yes, sir. It is based on the brotherhood fraternity scheme. Basically.
And today how many members you have?
We have 13,000.
13,000 members in all.
Only
13,000.
It should be in lakhs.
It should be in lakhs, but it is...
Very true. We promote on such occasions, like in all the central working committee, even in central council meeting, even in state presidents of secretaries officers meet. We always present our presentation. Everybody wants to be...
If a person dies, how much ultimately he ends up getting?
About 8 or 9 lakhs he will get. Each family will get about...
So each family will get around. So 13,000 multiplied by 100?
Yeah,
100%.
70 rupees.
70 rupees.
70. Because after 25 years of contribution, he has not to pay.
Okay.
But he remains the members of the social security scheme.
So approximately 9.1 lakh rupees.
More than that, sir.
More than that.
Yes,
so, so he is spending only 10,000 rupees.
Every year he is not spending more than 4,000 or 5,000 rupees.
And then he will have to pay for 25 years.
25 years. After 25 years. Continuous. 25 years. So then he has not to pay.
And he will remain the president, member of that scheme.
And till he dies.
So how many average deaths are occurring in IMA membership every year?
About 30 to 50.
Every year? Yes. That's not a small number. And
so if we consider 1,000, then it is between 3 to 5 per 1,000 member.
Okay. And do you have some statistics about this age scale, people who are dying?
Sure, we
at
have.
What age they are dying?
Majority at normal, that is between 50 to 70.
That's not normal. For doctors, it should be much more than that.
Rare cases, year, one or two young doctors also die.
How many doctors we have in the scheme who are above the age of 80?
Above 80?
No, I think only 250 members are more than 70. Only because we have restricted. Initially, the members were more than 60. Otherwise, now we are not taking members above 60 years.
Okay, like an insurance company, that you don't want to take anybody above the age of 60. You will take youngsters.
We prefer, sir, that any doctor of member of IMA can become the member at the early age. That will be better and preferable. They want to become member at the age of 59 or 60. It is not fair for the scheme and also for the members.
Do you also have a breakup of these 13,000 members?
Yes, yes. All breakups.
Majority of them are from which state?
Majority are from Gujarat. Only
doesn't it look like to be that it's only one state is promoting it?
No, because initially Gujarat had his own scheme, that is Gujarat Social Security.
And that got converted into a national scheme.
Then we have taken the permission from the Indian Medical Association
to start at a national.
So it is the same scheme which got converted? No, they still have.
They still have. Out of 13 or 14,000 people, they have about 10,000 members.
Two-thirds members
are in with Gujarat scheme. Because of this is a national scheme, majority of doctors are initially not interested to become the member. So this scheme will go to Indian Medical Association, Delhi or other places.
Any other place.
So initially, now somewhat interested members are coming from all states. I think about, we have also…
Highest of Gujarat, then comes Andhra Pradesh, then also comes Maharashtra and Kerala.
North Delhi is zero.
Delhi is more than 250, sir. That is sure.
If a member from one state to 250 members or more, we give one representative from that state.
We invite him as a managing committee member of our scheme.
So, at about 7 managing committee members are there.
At present.
Anything else you want to say about the scheme?
Nah, it is a brotherhood scheme to help our doctor friend. This is not an insurance scheme, that I definitely did. It is to give about 100 rupees, nobody will go to his house. But by this scheme, we can help the nominee of the member. That is the main advantage of this scheme. And we have to promote not as an insurance, it is to promote as a…
Something like an LIC.
This is not an LIC.
No, something like on the lines of an LIC, you are going to get only death benefit, not the sickness benefit.
Yeah.
The difference between a health insurance and a life insurance.
We are not taking his health checkup, anything we are not taking.
If he dies from suicide, homicide or by any death, accident death, we are giving without any reason. We are promoting this scheme, except in for 1 year is a lock-in period.
First year.
In that we can even give him in accident case, not in regular.
In accident case, we give after any day.
So what Dr. Kirti Patel and Dr. Yogendra S. Modi says is that IMA also has its own national social security scheme. I personally feel, as a vice president elect of the association, lot of members should join that, and that can be a really good social service for ourselves. We are part of a national extended family group. The only thing I can suggest them is that these 13,000 members should be, we should send them emails, we should keep them in contact, and we should tell them how to stay healthy, because our basic purpose is that these 13,000 people should die and not at a younger age. So if we can create for our members that how to remain healthy, then so that doctors don't die early, and if we add that to the National Social Security Scheme, more and more members will join. Well, thank you very much for joining us in this show.
Thank you very much.
And that's all for today. We'll come back with one more show. Till that, goodbye. Thank you.